Greetings everyone. Welcome to yet another content from Throttle Alpha. Today we are taking a look at a special helmet because you're getting a lot more than expected in a budget which is very friendly for your pocket. Yes, we're taking a look at the Axis Eagle helmet and we're gonna break down everything you need to know about this helmet. Initially, I would like to start off with the shell for this helmet. It has a thermoplastic shell. And for whatever it has to offer, it looks pretty good. I have no complaints about durability, and one good addition along with the shell is the rubber guards added in the front and in the back of the helmet. It will help your helmet stay in a very ideal position in flat surfaces and also work in case of hand drops. Like it happens at times that whenever you're parked or you're carrying your helmet, we at times drop our helmet. So I think in this budget, adding up rubber barriers or rubber protection alongside the chassis area is a really useful material for the shell. And another point I'd like to add up with the shell is that I love the graphics work they're offering in this price. They have a lot of graphics to offer, and especially this particular graphics really attracted me in ways because you have the perfect matte finish provided with this graphics. A few certain areas could be improved. For example, you have a color burn in this area, but I think that these problems aren't much catchy, whereas the whole thing as a whole looks very catchy when you're riding and wearing this. So I think hats off with the shell design and the graphics work done with this helmet. And even for the gloss finishes, for the budget this helmet's being sold at, excellent job done with the gloss graphics as well. I think if anyone's looking for a secondary helmet mainly, like if you have a very expensive helmet and you're not able to carry it everywhere, like we live in a country where helmet theft is a very big problem. So if you're looking for a budget helmet that really delivers with a lot of high budget helmets too, I think this helmet is a perfect choice. As a secondary option too, I would never mind keeping this Axis Eagle as a secondary choice because I am really impressed with the helmet and the way it looks especially. Now, coming to the second point for the Axis Eagle, the ventilation. Now you have two primary vents, one at the top and one in the chin area. Now basically, if I have to compare a few of those helmets with this one, like the MT Stinger or the SMK Twister or certain helmets in these prices, I would say the air vent especially works better for the Axis Eagle. And it's tested because I have used the MT Stinger for over 2 years. And once I wore this and I was coming back from the place I got this, I think instantly I realized that, all right, in this budget, I am actually drawing more air than the previous helmets that I've used. So I think it's a good job done with the airflow. And even if I'm to include the thermal resistance for this helmet, I would say that for our hot and humid weather, it did not fail to deliver. Like, it's not the best that I've encountered. If I compare those 8, 9 or 10K helmets with this, yes, the thermal resistance is a bit better for those helmets, but I think for the Axis Eagle, it is delivering to the price point it's being sold at. So hats off with the air circulation and thermal resistance too. And the visor is pretty much clear enough. One certain good factor about this graphics is that you're getting the black visor for free with this helmet. Like, the black visor is included with this helmet. And to include viewing angles, of course, these are very conventional in terms of viewing angles. These weren't racing oriented. You cannot expect the top tier viewing angle from these helmets. But if I compared the viewing angle or the visor quality with the 4,000 taka budget or 5,000 taka budget range helmet, this one's the same. It delivers in the same extent and it's pretty good. But with the black visor, I observed one thing with the black visor that this fogs a little bit lesser than the clear visor. Like, the black visor did stand out a bit better in terms of rainy situations. And in terms of night riding, I would say I prefer the clear visor. Though I did ride in rainy conditions, but I think the fogging problem, it could be a bit better. Like, it didn't fog very much, but then again, it was, even though it has anti-fog inserts, it was fogging up to an extent. And another thing is that you have a visor lock in the bottom, which completely seals up the visor with the bottom area. So good addition done with this part as well, because I've used the MT Stinger for a very long period of time and the Stinger misses out in those things. So I think these small things really matter a lot. And this visor has a thickness of about 2.2 millimeters. I would like to add another thing about the module is that they have a better distribution than the previous helmets that I've tested for the Axis Draken. It felt a bit heavy when you went out for long cruises or in intercity conditions, but compared to the Axis Draken, this has a way better weight distribution, weighing about 1600 grams. Yes, it's a heavy helmet, but the Eagle has a way, way better distribution than Axis Draken. So good job with the weight distribution as well. And the module has a dual certification working for it. It's both EC and DOT certified. So hats off with the certifications too, because I don't have much problem with certifications, but a few people really dig DOT certified helmets or EC certified helmets. So in this price point, you are getting dual certifications. That's a very good job done with this helmet. So jumping to the interior for the Axis Eagle, the first thing you would notice when you open the Axis Eagle is that you have an integrated bread deflector, and you also get an additional chin curtain with it as well. So that's a good job done. And the inner padding also has a different color texture in comparison to the chassis shell. So it's a pretty catchy job when you're wearing the helmet. And another thing that would really catch everyone's attention in this $40 price point is that you have a very good padding included. Like, even if I compared the padding layout and the construction work done with a lot of expensive helmets, I think the padding construction has been a really good job done with this helmet. And I really get baffled because you're also getting a reflective panel in the bottom. Like, when you drop light, these panels reflect. And you have a pretty sturdy micrometric belt also included along the padding. And if I have to include the comfort for the padding, I think this does a better job than the SMK Twister or the MT Stinger. So the rival products or those products in this budget frame, I think the padding has been a good job done with the Eagle model especially. And these are washable and removable liners, so you can remove them anytime you want and give them a wash. The leather work or the artificial leather work done in the padding area is really catchy for the eyes. And the padding has an anti-allergic fabric included. I don't think this padding will wick sweat very easily because it has a hand texture that's dotty, so I think that it won't wick sweat that easily. But then again, the texture feels very comfortable and the padding looks durable too. So good job done with the padding section as well. So these Axis helmets are designed and the R&D work is done in Spain, side brand for MT helmets. So I think in that aspect, you don't have much to complain or you don't have any reliability issues with this helmet because they're coming from good creators. And I would like to add up two cons with this helmet. One, noise reduction. I think the noise reduction could be a bit better. Nothing that complainable because the padding really covers the ear portion up. So the noise feels pretty minimum till the 50 to 60 kilometers per hour speed range, but after that range you certainly feel a bit of a noise. And yes, you don't have the addition of an integrated sun visor. And another good addition or a pro is that you have a dedicated ear pocket for communicators, or you have that space included for communicators, so this would be a great touring option in that sense too. So this was our take on the Axis Eagle helmet. I hope this review helped you understand this helmet a bit better, and I would recommend anyone looking for a secondary option or a budget option in terms of traveling someplace you're not convenient or carrying your expensive helmet. So I think this helmet really fills that pocket up, that it's convenient, it's cheap, and it really delivers in this price point. So this was our take. Do stay connected with Throttle Alpha. We'll come up with more contents very, very soon. Do check our Instagram profile out and do visit us on Facebook too. Till then, take care, stay safe. Thank you.